else. Humans just hear bells when I talk. This is the story of Peter Pan and a girl named Wendy who believed in him. It begins in the Darling Family Nursery.
Here, to the dotted line here, to the X marks the... Oh no. Oh no, my shirt!
George, this is no time to play with the children. We are late.
This was my last clean shirt. You are pirates.
I'm not a pirate. I'm an Indian now.
I'm a mermaid.
Wendy, what kinds of stories are you putting into these boys' heads? Thank you. Oh, they're all slobbery. Wendy, why were these cufflinks under the bed?
That's where Peter Pan hid the pirate's treasure.
You and your ridiculous stories, Captain Crook, Peter Pirate.
Peter Pan.
Pan Pirate Poppycock.
Now, George.
And now, George. Now, George, we'll have his say. Wendy, this is your last night sleeping in this room.
What?
You need to be a proper lady. You can't roughhouse with your brothers. You can't stuff their heads with silly stories. We will have some dignity in this house.
Ah! Oh, no! Poor Nana!
Poor Nana? This is the last straw. Nana out for good.
No!
But, George, the children love her.
And she loves them, but she's not even a proper nursemaid. She's a dog.
Goodbye, Nana.
Don't look at me like that. It's nothing personal. It's just that, well, you're not really a nurse at all. You're a dog. And children aren't puppies. They're people. Sooner or later, Nana, people need to grow up.
I don't want to grow up if it means becoming a proper lady.
Why did Dad call Peter Pan Poppycock?
That's me!
Now, he loves you very much.
Don't close the window. He might come back.
Who?
Peter Pan. I found a shadow. He must have dropped it. He comes here each night from Neverland, which is the second sunrise.
No such place exists. Good night.
Finding stuff like this. You used to be able to find the lost boy in no time.
It can be incredibly frustrating trying to communicate with Peter when he gets distracted.
Tink, why are you chattering so much? I found it! Oh, I knew I'd find it quicker than you. Look how amazing my shadow looks. Now I just need to attach it back. Get me some soap.
Oh my gosh, it's you! I knew you were real! I knew it! I knew it!
You're Peter Pan and you're real, not just a tale I told.
I'm Wendy, Wendy Moira Angela Darling. You came back for your shadow, right? Wait, are you trying to attach that with soap? Shadow.
Girls talk too much.
Excuse me?
First of all, your nanny's a dog, and that's weird. And second, she attacked me while I was floating outside and grabbed my shadow.
Oh, Nana.
I come every night to listen to your stories.
But my stories are all about you.
That's why I like them. I tell them to the Lost Boys, but I forget some of the details. Whoa! Look how amazing I look with my shadow back on! I grow and I'm happy.
Oh, Peter, I'm so unhappy. Tomorrow I have to grow up and become a proper lady.
Grow up?
Tomorrow I'm leaving the nursery, which means no more stories.
What? I won't have it. I'm taking you to Neverland. You'll never grow up there.
But what would my mom say?
What's a mom?
What's a mom? Someone who loves you and tells you stories.
Good. You can be our mom.
Ow! Ow!
Hey, stop it, Tink.
There's one more thing you should know. Although you see me as a normal-sized girl, I'm really just a 2-inch tall fairy, which is why my voice sounds like Belle's when it's 2 minutes.
Look, she's there. Now she's there.
Now, I really shouldn't have pulled Wendy's hair, but she was going to tell Peter more stories about himself. Peter Pan is an excellent boy, but he can be very conceited.
John, wake up! Peter Pan is here!
Whoa! What's that?
A fairy. One is born each time a baby laughs its first laugh.
Tink, Wendy is my friend, and she's coming with us.
Peter's gonna take us to Neverland!
We're going to Neverland! wonderful thought.
Any happy little thought?
Uh-huh.
Like toys at Christmas?
Sleigh bells, snow?
Yep, watch me now. Here I go!
He can fly!
He can fly!
He can fly!
Now you try!
Oh, think of a mermaid's lagoon. I did eat the magic moon.
This won't do. What's the matter with you? All it takes is faith and trust. Oh, and something I forgot. Dust.
Dust?
Just a little bit of pixie dust. Tink, I order you.
Here I sit, stuck
in Neverland plotting my revenge on that diabolic Peter Pan. Curse you, Pan!
Feeling poetic, Captain?
Oh, if I could only find his secret lair, I'd capture him and plunge me cutlass deep into his sickly sweet heart. But enough! This must be finished. Smee, bring me my map.
Maybe his and his boys hide out in Mermaid's Lagoon.
We've trod the very depths of Mermaid's Lagoon.
Maybe in a cave above Cannibal Cove?
We've dynamited every cave in Cannibal Cove.
Possibly somewhere in the Indian Territory?
No, no, no. Of course! I am brilliant! Those Indians know the island better than anyone. You must know where that insolent knave hides each night. We must capture Tiger Lily!
Chief's daughter?
And if Tiger Lily won't tell us, we'll boil her in oil. What do you say to that?
That ain't good form.
Blast good form! Did Pan show good form when he did this? To me?
Well, I thought you liked her for combing your hair and scratching.
Tis true. If I were a mother, I'd pray to have my children born with this instead of this.
Well, maybe, in a way, we could thank Pan.
Oh, but Smee! He threw my hand into the crocodile's maw! And the beast has been licking his lips for the rest of me ever since.
But luckily, the croc also swallowed the clock, which gives us the tick-tock, tick-tock, so if we can get away before he reaches you. Why? I can almost hear it now!
Oh, no! The brute is here! Save me! Save me!
You over there! What are you doing?
Thank you.
Wendy. Bird? Whose arrow is this? You, blockhead! I bring you someone amazing to tell you stories, and you just kill her?
She was gonna tell us stories?
Hawk, you are hereby sentenced to... Wait! My mind is made up, and yet I feel something is holding me back.
Is it your conscience?
No.
Look, she's not dead.
That was fun.
Wait, what happened?
The arrow hit the button on my nightgown.
Why would you do this?
Tink said you wanted us to.
Tink? Tinkerbell! You are hereby charged with high treason. Are you guilty or not? Guilty. Well then, I hereby banish you forever! Fine, but for 1 week. Now scram! Come on, Wendy. Let's see if you can find Hook and Payne for this morning's stunt. John, you're in charge. Lost Boys, follow him wherever he leads.
Race ya.
So, you're the Lost Boys.
How'd you get lost?
When babies from their cribs, they come here to Neverland. Why are there no lost girls?
Girls are too clever to fall out of their cribs.
And why do you dress like that?
Camouflage.
Then we should march. Now what?
Just lead.
Following the leader, the leader, the leader. We're off on an adventure to catch the scouts.
This feels kind of silly.
Yeah.
But I kind of like it.
Yeah. Sometimes you win, sometimes we win.
Okay, you win this time, but turn us loose.
Turn us loose? You mean this is only a game? Yeah, and it sometimes feels a little ridiculous to talk like that. But there is one important thing. Where have you hidden Tiger Lily?
What? We ain't got the princess?
Yes, you do. Tell me else.
Honest, we don't.
Then that is a big people from across the ocean lie. If Tiger Lily isn't brought back by sunset, Lost Boys get burned at the stake.
No!
we drowned her, we'd apologize.
Truly, we would.
Fine, then. You tell her your adventure.
All right. Want to hear about the time where I threw Hook's hand to the crocodile? There I was on Marooner's Rock, and...
Wait, Wendy! Tiger Lily! The princess of the island! And she's a prisoner!
Knew Hook was up to no good.
How do we rescue her?
Take it from here.
Come here, I have an idea.
Oh, with that I could set you free. But I, here's the rub. You know where that scurvy rat pan lives, and I do not. Tell me or die.
You dog.
Am I not a man of me words, me?
Yes. Always, Captain. Now come on, Tiger Lily. It's Davy Jones' locker for you.
And remember your sacred beliefs. There is no path through water to the happy hunting ground. Now speak.
Now, Peter.
Odds, bogs, hammer and tongs. Oh, what a rogue and peasant hook I am. I'm James Hook, captain of the Jolly Roger.
But if you are Hook, then who am I?
A codfish.
Have we all this time been captained by a codfish?
You fool! This is merely some witchcraft. Stay here with the captive. I'll get to the bottom of this.
Mr. Smee?
Yes, Captain?
Release the princess and take her back to her people.
But which Captain Hook are you?
The real Captain Hook.
Okay, but I told him you Indians would never betray Peter Pan.
Here's your spirit, Smee.
It's Pan!
Insolent name.
Come and get me.
Floating on water again, you cheat. Insolent boy, I'll slash you to ribbons.
You'll cut me to pieces.
I'll slit your gizzard.
Not so fast.
Peter!
Wendy! In the back, Captain?
Clinging to the brisket.
I've got you this time, Pan.
I say, Captain, do you hear something?
No!
Mr. Crocodile, do you like codfish?
Smee! Help!
I'm coming, Captain.
I'll get you, Pan, I swear! The next time we will be worse than anything you can imagine!
Sweet victory. Let's go.
Thank you, brave girl from far away. Because that was a close one. Come back to our camp. Let's celebrate.
Absolutely.
In pantomime, he says, Peter Pan, mighty warrior, save Tiger Lily, make Chief very glad.
Actually, I was just stretching my arms. Are you the one who saved Tiger Lily?
Yep, it was me.
Peter?
Then I hereby rename you Little Flying Eagle. You can join our tribe.
Flying Eagle! Flying Eagle!
Tell him, Peter, I help too.
I will. Can I ask you something, Chief? And it's important. Can you teach me some Indian words?
Well, we don't really know any. But when you want to sound official, we say, Hanumanaganda!
Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda! Hanumanaganda!
That's fun. And one more thing. Why do they call you Braves?
Because we are brave.
But why?
Live. I must have my revenge.
Well, you know, Captain, we should always forget all this pan stuff and never land to go back to the healthy life. Ships and cutting throats.
Aye. But what light through yonder window breaks?
Still appointed, Captain?
No. The light over there. Why, it's Peter Pan's fairy Tinkerbell. Oh, but why is she crying?
Well, I wouldn't want this to go any further, but the cook told me that the first mate told him that Pan has banished Tinkerbell.
Oh! Smee! You should have told me at once! That gives me a plan!
But how are you going to talk?
I speak, Pixie.
What's she saying?
Oh, she's saying she's very depressed. Poor thing.
not speak pixie. He just said the turnip is taking a siesta. Two feelings to exist at once. And at the time, I was really steamed at Peter. I wish I could undo it, but I did it. I told Captain Hook where Peter Pan and Wendy were hiding.
Eagle greets his braves. Greetings.
Greetings, Chief!
Greetings.
Big Chief greets little mother. Greetings.
Ugh. Oh, Wendy, is that all you have to say? Everyone else thinks I'm wonderful.
You took all the credit for saving Tiger Lily.
Didn't I save Tiger Lily?
We both did.
Sure.
You're conceited.
I know.
Well, you shouldn't be.
Okay, I won't be conceited. I'm awfully good at not being conceited. I could be the most wonderfully unconceited person in the world. Big Chief Flying Eagle, magnificently unconceited.
Michael, John, take off that war paint and get ready for bed.
Brave, no sleep. Go for many days without sleep. Brave, when hears story.
Yeah, story!
Peter said he came to tell us stories!
All right. Which one do y'all want to hear?
Stories about Peter Pan!
What other stories do you like? Cinderella. Oh, or Sleeping Beauty.
Boring. We want Pan.
Pan! 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 Pan!
Mom, tell them stories about Peter Pan!
What did you say?
Mom, tell us stories about Peter Pan.
Michael, you don't actually think I'm your mother. John?
Well, moms tell stories, and you tell us stories. So you must be our mom.
Oh, but I've just been playing. You have a real mom at home. Michael, John, remember?
Did she have silky ears and wear fur coat?
That was Nana.
I think I had a mother once.
I was in my room.
I think it's time we go home.
No go home. Stay many moons. Have big fun time.
Now, Peter, we've got to be practical, and Indian braves don't even talk like that. Do you just want to stay here and grow up like savages?
Savages!
You need a real mom.
Well, my villainous crew, here we are at Peter Pan's hideout. Finally, after all these years.
Tell us about our mother. She's the lovely voice that bids you goodnight.
Kisses your cheek, whisper sleep time. Your mother and mine. Your mother and mine.
Oh yeah, I think I remember now.
I don't remember yet. Tell me more. Mothers work hard to make sure you have everything you need. And they're good to you and they protect you. Remember?
No, Peter will save us.
Yeah. No, he won't. Peter only thinks of himself.
Ah, the disillusionment of youth. My dear, you are right. Peter won't be doing anything for anyone anymore. Well, not in one location, anyway. You see, we've left a present for Peter.
A sort of surprise suite, you might say.
Why, I can see our friend now. Perhaps he's just reading the tender inscription.
To Peter, with love from Wendy. Do not eat until 6 o'clock.
I've cut the pie packed with the rarest and finest TNT. Cooked to a delicious grain, which at precisely 6 p.m. will go kaboom!
Kaboom!
No, I'll promise not to touch him. Various, please help me.
Tink, why didn't you call sooner?
I was embarrassed.
Why didn't you tell Hook where Peter Pan was hiding?
Hush.
Since when does a fairy get jealous of a human?
She gets a little overeager sometimes.
Tink, maybe we should discuss how to avoid situations like this in the future.
Jealous of Wendy because you want to be the best at everything. But you have your own talents too, okay?
No time. Open the jar. We can't just tell the story. We need to save it.
But fleet the time. Pan has but 18 seconds to live. 15 seconds. 13 seconds.
12 seconds. 11 seconds. Gosh, I want to eat it now.
10, 9, 8,
7, 6,
5, 4.
Oh, hey, Ting. What's up? I can't hear you with all your friends. Hey there, Silver Mist, Rosetta, Fawn, Vidia, wait, no, sorry, you're here, Odessa, you're Liria, and hey, give me back my pie!
Tink, we have to go, or this pie is gonna explode!
Tink, what do we do?
I'll do it!
Oh, no.
It was a bomb. It was Hook. If it hadn't been for Tink. You saved my life, Tink. Tinkerbell, are you all right? I know you're sorry for trying to get Wendy killed, and I forgive you. What? Wendy's in trouble. Let's go.
And now which will it be? A life of piratic servitude? Or no life at all?
Captain Hook, we'll never join your crew.
As you wish. Ladies first.
Goodbye, boys.
Goodbye, sister.
your turn. Wendy.
But you defeated Hook. You're the captain.
All right, I'll be captain. If you play the leader.
All right then, Captain Pan. Take a straight past the second star to the right. Tinkerbell. Oh, why, of course I forgive you, Tinkerbell. But right now I need you to make the ship fly so it can take us home. Would you do that for me?
All right, you swabs. All off with you. We're casting off. Man the captains. Hoist the anchor. Tink, add the pixie dust.
Think of the happiest things. It's the same as having wings.
Come on.
What?
No.
Just humor them, George.
Think of
take it back. Step away from the window.
It's easy and hard. You can fly, you can fly, you can...
Look, it's his ship. I remember.
George, what are you talking about?
Nana, did you see that? You know, I have the strangest feeling. When I was a boy, I saw a ship like that. There was an island and a boy who wouldn't grow up. Oh, Wendy, I understand. I think I understand now.
Oh, Dad.
Come on, Tink. Time to go back to Neverland.